Cause this does not say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up, tired of the way that things have been.
Hello and welcome to a new video. Today we are going to be talking about our tournament that is up and coming. It will be the rules, ban list, deck profiles, and times and advertisements. So, let's get started. I'm here with my good friend Jamie Jokes.
Hello everyone.
Hey. Right, we'll get straight into it with the rules. I'll hand it over to Jamie.
Right, thank you. Thank you for letting me go on your channel for the first time.
It is fine.
No problem. So, before I start the rules, we've done these tournaments 3 times anyway. For
yes.
fun.
Yes.
So we both had a discussion quick saying, well, it all started over a YouTube video that I did.
That was, yeah.
And then you discussed saying, wouldn't it be cool if we did our Yu-Gi-Oh tournaments, but on YouTube?
Right? Exactly.
You clever man. So there. We've already written down the rules for the tournament.
Yes.
So yeah.
We'll run you through them now.
Yeah. Well, it's not much of a rule, but more of a thing describing.
Yeah, these are our rules, they're for our tournament, so they may not be you may not agree with them, but that is not up to us, that's up to you, and you are entitled to your opinion.
That's true. Well, the first one is, there will be 4 groups of 4, meaning a total of 16 decks.
Right.
So yeah, so we'll have 4 groups, each group will have 4 decks in them. Obviously 4, 8, 12, 16. Right, obviously, this is the first tournament, which goes to... It's not really a rule, but what this is that because it's the first tournament, there will be no qualifying rounds.
Which I thought we both came to the decision is fairer than having a lot of qualifiers then doing the tournament.
Yeah, rather than having all of our personal decks and all the small decks we have, put them all against and then play, I don't know, like... well, we have to find out how qualifying would work.
Yeah.
So, the second main rule will be this. All decks will be drawn randomly.
Yeah, I have got online a random wheel generator. All names will be placed into the generator. It will be spun, and the names will match, and we'll see who goes against who.
Exactly. But the draw will be in order of groups. So the first deck that will be called out will be in group 1.
Yep.
The second deck that gets drawn will be in group 2.
Mm.
And so forth. So then the fifth deck will be in group 1.
Yeah, so 1, 2, 3, 4, repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4, repeat. Yeah.
They will be a best of 3 in any of the Yu-Gi-Oh tournament.
In other words, yeah.
They'll be in a best of 3. Be played within a best of 3 like any other Yu-Gi-Oh game tournament. You know the drill, yo.
Yeah.
Not to make the tournament long, they'll only play each other once.
So
we won't have, for example, Red Icy Destiny. They play the other, then Red Icy plays the other 2 decks, and then it goes back to Red Icy Destiny and the other 2.
Yeah.
So it's just 1 game, so that's probably 6 matches in total in each group.
Yeah.
Right then, the top 2 in each group will go to a quarterfinals. Right, I've written them down how it goes. So the quarterfinal, this is how we'll go. The game 1 of quarterfinal 1 will be winner of group 1 versus runner-up of group 4.
Yep.
Match 2 will be winner of group 2 versus runner-up of group 3.
Yeah, so there's a fair way.
Yeah, and then 3, which will be runner-up group 1 versus winner group 4, and then the last will be runner-up group 2 versus winner of group 3. That way there we won't have, well, I think it's easier to do it like that, personally.
Yeah.
Semi-finals now will be winner of quarter-final 1 versus winner of quarterfinal four.
Yeah.
And winner of quarterfinal two will play against winner of quarterfinal three.
Yeah.
That way, then, we won't have a rematch thing, then.
Yeah. If you know what I mean. There'll be no rematching,
So there'll be no rematching of winner of group one against winner of, winner of group one against runner-up of group one.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean.
Yeah.
And we're actually going to be having a bronze final as well.
Yeah.
Which is the loser of semi-final one against the loser of semi-final two. Whoever wins that will be third, and the loser will be fourth. And then obviously, the finals.
Aye.
The two winners of each of the semi-finals will play against each other, and then the winner of that is crowned champion.
Yeah, and so that is our rule set. It's pretty straightforward.
Exactly. We've got a couple more rules just in case to go through.
Go for it.
So I'll go through them as quickly as possible.
Yep.
Top two in each group that already qualify to the quarterfinals will automatically qualify to the next tournament.
Correct.
Therefore, we won't choose again. So we'll be like, right, these eight decks are made it in the quarterfinals.
Yeah.
So, yeah. There will be tiers on qualifying.
Yeah.
As such. Well, tier one will be the top tiers that came first, second, third, and fourth.
Yeah.
They will be known as tier one. And then tier twos were the four decks that lost in the quarterfinals.
Mm, yeah.
We've only recently just made a new qualifying system, but we go back to the old one just for YouTube for now.
Yeah.
Which is tier three and four will be the qualifiers.
Yeah.
So whoever wins in each qualifying will be tier three, and the runners up in them will be tier four.
Yeah, that's like a plan to make.
Exactly. Each tiers will be drawn separately, but not in this tournament, because this is the first one. We'll go over the ban list pretty soon.
Yeah, the ban list will be up next.
Right. Here's one. If you win, you will get 3 points.
Yeah.
If you draw, you get 1 point. And if you lose, 0 points. Now, some of you may ask, what do you mean draw? We'll come back to that. Now, there will be point difference. For example, Karibos are playing, I don't know, I'm just naming random decks now. Karibo v Red Eyed. Karibo lose 2-0.
Yeah.
Red Eyes will be still, Karibo will be minus 2. And let's say Destiny Heroes beat, I don't know, let's say they beat Red Eyes 2-1.
Yeah.
Destiny Heroes will be plus 1. But because Red Eyes was already on plus 2 and they lost by 1, they'll be plus 1.
Yeah.
Now then, we'll only put extra games if 2 or 3, depending on how it is, of how many decks there... Well, yeah.
Yeah, another one.
If, say, 3 or 2 decks have the exact same win-loss, draw, point difference, and points...
Yeah.
And they're all the same. And we're like, well, we have a winner, but 2 and 2nd and 3rd are exactly the same.
Mm.
What do we do? We have an extra game.
Yeah.
That extra game will be a best of 3.
Yeah.
To be fair. The winner of that best of 3 will become 2nd or 3rd, depending on the outcome.
Yeah.
Right. Right. Here we go to the bit of a tricky situation. What happens if both of my decks are playing? Well, then.
During COVID, that's the best we can do.
Yep. Yeah, we're still in lockdown.
Yeah.
The only thing we can do is if we ask our brothers to duel us in that duel. Both, for example, my two of my decks are playing. Mm-hmm. I'll ask my brother, can you play? If he can, we'll do. And then I will record it and send it to Adam to edit.
Yeah.
And it goes the same for you as well.
Yeah, exactly. I'll ask my brother, and if he can, he will do it. I will record it, edit it, and it'll be uploaded.
Exactly. Now, here's the problem. This is why I said draw. If none of our brothers can make it, in the next match, well, before the next match, we'll be like, we're very sorry, we can't make this deal happen.
No.
Therefore, it will count as a draw, a one-all draw.
Yeah.
Right. I think that is all for the rules. If we need to say more, we'll probably say it in a Wink Wink podcast.
Yeah, which will be uploaded pretty soon, yeah.
Right, what's next on the list?
Ban list.
Right then, let me find that list. Right then. We're going to fire through the ban list. We've done this on our tournament, and we're pretty sure we're going to keep it the same.
Again, it is for our purposes. We just, if you don't hear the card that you've, and you're wondering where's that card, it's probably not even going to be in the tournament, so we haven't bothered using it. So,
yeah. If we don't mention a card, it'll probably, whatever it is on that ban list, it'll stay as it is.
Yeah, and chance of you seeing it is very slim.
For example, if you'd be like, well, how come you didn't talk about Harvey's Feather Duster?
Yeah.
Then if we don't talk about it, whatever it is on that ban list, it'll stay there.
Yeah.
So if it's at two, instead of us saying, should we keep it at two?
Yeah, rather than going through all the hundreds of cards, it's a lot easier if we just do it this way.
Yeah, we're basically going to go through Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournament 3's ban list that we've done personally. So it's basically going to be the same. The ban list is going to stay the same, except for the cards that we're going to list now.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Go for it.
Pot of Greed.
Mm-hmm.
We've decided to put it at 3.
Simply because it's not game-altering, it's not going to win you the duel. Well, it might, but it's not going to just OP overdo your opponent so hard it's unbelievable. So it's pretty normal cast card, yeah.
Yeah, but as again, if it does become OP, the next tournament...
Yeah, it'll be edited, yeah.
Or we put it up banned.
Yeah.
Even if we don't use it as much in this, it'll probably stay at...
Because we'd probably go to the end of the tournament and review what cards we thought was too overpowered and cut what we need to cut.
True. The second card we'll talk is Grace or Charity. Now, when we played this in the first tournament, my brother was involved in it. He's not now. And he ran 3 Grace or Charities. The problem is his deck is being rebuilt, so it's now out of play.
Yeah.
Therefore, we have decided to ban Grace or Charity.
For now, anyway.
Here's a few quick ones. The all 5 pieces of Exordia. We've decided, should we put out 2 or let's keep it at 1? After much thought, we've decided to keep it at 1.
Yeah, goes more, what's the word, challenging for you.
Yeah. Monster Reborn, we decided to keep at 1.
Yeah, because that seems to work for everyone.
Soul Charge. It's currently banned on the ban list, but we've decided to put it at 1.
Yeah.
Obviously, it has a big comeback where you can special
That could win you the game, yeah.
But obviously, you can't battle and you take 1,000 for each monster.
I do believe that's right, yeah.
Raigeki. Simple, we've kept that at 1. Terraforming. It's currently at 1 on the ban list, I think.
I think it is, yeah.
But we've decided to put at 3.
Because, again, it's not game-altering. It doesn't really do much. It only does one thing, really, so it can't really branch off into different alternative options.
You could combo into it, but at the same time, our decks haven't. So that's why we decided to press 3. Upstart Goblin, easy, at 1. You draw 1, your opponent gains 1,000. Simple.
Yeah.
For Phantom Knights of Rusty Bardish, I think is how you pronounce it.
Do believe so.
we've decided to keep that at one, because in the previous tournament, in tournament two, we popped it at two and it won the tournament.
Yeah, it just slaughtered everything, yeah.
It did feel a bit...
too much.
Overpowered. Yeah. So we've decided, we put it at one. Supreme King Dragon Starving Venom. originally, I wanted it at two, because I wanted to build a Zark deck.
Mm.
But at the same time, it's not the deck that I've got. It's basically like a structure deck with just random cards in. It's not as good, but because I'm not running that deck, the Zark deck in this tournament, that's already one deck I'm not planning in this one.
Yeah.
As Supreme King Dragonstone then will be banned.
Yeah. You're not going to have cards I'm not going to use, there's no point.
Yeah. If it's only in the one deck, there's no point putting out one if it's not in another deck.
Exactly.
Astrograss Sorcerer, again, banned. I was going to be in the Zark deck I was going to build, and I don't have that card, so it's going to stay banned.
Yeah.
Harpy's Feather Duster. Now that's one that came off the ban list, and it's currently at one. So we decided, well, keep it at one. We'll see how it goes. Now here's an odd card that Adam.
yeah, this one, yeah.
It is Inferno Tempest. I can't remember what it does. Do you have
when
the card on
you? When you take 3,000 or more points of damage, you banish all cards from your deck and graveyard from play. So in other words, you can't do anything.
we've decided to put that on one, actually, just in case.
Yeah, like I only have one of them, but I don't actually run it, so, you know, so I might in the future.
Yeah.
For a laugh.
The reason why we kept that on one, because, you, as you said, you might end up actually putting it in one of your decks.
Yeah.
So, it's a maybe one.
Yeah.
If he doesn't, then we'll tell you during the draw phase or the podcast saying, look, he's decided not to, so it's going to be banned.
Okay.
Foolish Burial, easy enough. One.
Yeah, easy enough.
Ash Blossom. No. I run three of them in my Red Eyes deck.
Yeah.
And because it was a bit unfair that every time you, was it like you play D cubes effect?
Or yeah, exactly. Yeah. Badly, yeah.
I'll ash it. Instead of keeping it at three, we decided to put it at two.
Yeah, make it a bit more fair. Yeah.
Yeah. It's not too, these decks aren't too competitive.
No, they're just for fun mainly.
Yeah, they're mostly for fun, but they can feel competitive.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Those are the current cards we thought that we'd be banning for at one, two, or three.
Yeah.
As Adam stated at the start of this, the rest of the cards that are on the ban list that we did not see will stay as they are.
Yeah. Because you're more likely to see them.
Exactly. Because there's no points, basically.
Yeah.
Right then. What's next on the list?
The decks.
Right then. Would you like to go first, or would you like...
I'll go first. Go on, why not? Well, first off, we're going to reveal four decks out of eight from either side. And then we're going to... the remaining decks were revealed in a later video.
So, as a surprise.
Exactly. So, the first deck I am running is Destiny Heroes. The Destiny Hero deck is my brother's personal deck. He loves this deck.
Yeah.
And it's quite powerful.
Yeah, because you did a deck list about that a couple of days ago.
I did, yes.
As well.
The other day I did do a deck list. Please check that out. Second...
Link in the description.
Next deck is a zombie deck. Now, the zombie deck is not your average zombie deck. It's more of a starter zombie deck. It's not meant...
Like a structure deck.
But I've had thrown a few new things in there for extra comfort. The next one I'll be running is the Earthbound Immortals.
That sounds cool. Yeah. Because you said you wanted to try... The past few times you've dealt with it...
Yeah.
You said that you want to make it better.
Yeah. The Earthbound Mortals has had an upgrade since our last tournament, and has a few new things in there, yeah.
Yeah, as you said, you in the last tournament we did, as we keep on keep mentioning this every time, that during our personal time, Earthbound Mortals were okay-ish.
Yeah.
But they're...
But now they should be much better because they got a few cards in them that can just win you the duel, shall we say. And the final deck I will be revealing is Dino Rampage. Dino Rampage is a dinosaur mixed with Dino Wrestlers. It is designed for a ball field control, mainly, and just to wiggle down your opponent's life points one by one, in other words.
I can see your Dino Wrestlers are getting good.
Yeah, they're getting better.
They get better. That's the point of these tournaments. Yeah. It's for fun, but at the same time, we're like, right, if I want this deck to go far, I need to make it better.
Exactly. Anyway, over to you.
Right, thank you very much. Now, as many of you already know, you've already seen the three videos of Adam.
Yeah.
Which are Red Eyes versus Destiny Heroes.
Yeah.
Please check out all three of his videos.
Yeah, the next one will be uploaded tomorrow, and that'll be the final part.
And then the podcast will be uploaded either on the same day or a different day.
Exactly.
We're not too sure yet.
Yeah.
We're not sure when this has been uploaded. My first deck, as you've already seen, is the Red Eyes Black Dragon. Now, this deck is very personal to me. I love the card. And I love it. Fun fact, my brother has a Blue Eyes deck, and that's his personal one, and he's very... It's like it's soul, but back to Red Eyes. It's my deck, my personal deck. It means a lot to me.
Yeah.
It's kind of a burning deck.
Hmm.
Where I try to burn my opponent. We won't go into too much detail, because we'll probably talk more in the podcast.
Yeah.
My second deck I'd like to show and announce is the Phantom Knight. You may have seen a snippet of one of them in the trailer. Yeah. Link in the description for the trailer. My Phantom Knight, what I try to do is I try to overlay as quick as I can. Overlay it as quick as I can, and then use effects, and then try to get Dark Rebellion Xyz out, and then get the rank up card.
Yeah.
And then just take your life, not life, but your attack points.
Yeah.
Basically. My third deck that I'd like to announce, it's okay. The Wind Dragon of Ra.
Hmm.
No, the reason why I say it's okay, it's got some of the cards from that new support that it got. The problem is I don't have the fusion cards, the Egyptian God Slime. I do not have that. So, I do apologise, but at the same time, these are only for fun.
Exactly.
So with the Ra, I just try to get Ra out fast as I can, and then hope that my opponent hasn't already given me damage, so I can give Ra an attack. Now, the fourth and final deck that I'm announcing today will make you think, and some of you think, and some of you will be like, aw, that's Karibo. I foreshadowed it a couple of minutes ago in that thing, the rules. I basically always wanted to make a Karibo deck for fun. And then when they announced the advent calendar with all the Karibo cards, I thought, I'm getting that. I've basically got that and a couple of other Karibo cards in there.
Mm.
But at the same time, it's not perfect. Like, I have got, like, three cards, but only one of certain cards. And I'm like, why are you running three cards when you need three of each of both? So, you probably see the images on your screen now with all the decks.
Yeah, they're probably there, yeah. Good.
Yeah. So, as I go through one by one quick again, so that for me it's Red Eyes, the Phantom Knight, the Winged Dragon of Ra, and Karibo.
And for me it is Destiny Heroes, Zombies, Earthbound Immortals, and Dino Rampage.
Exactly. Right, what's next on the list?
Times of videos being uploaded.
Right, the way we were going to discuss this was that we were going to record each round separate of the best of three.
Yep.
And then you were going to edit them together.
Yeah.
To make them one
video. Yeah, it'll be completion of them.
Yeah. Still kind of thinking of the tournament name. Well, Yu-Gi-Oh! World Cup. I have suggested one.
Yeah.
We'll see, just in case if we might change it a bit, but yeah.
Yeah.
Uploads. We're thinking of doing two a day.
Yeah.
So we could do the first game of, well, we're going to do groups separately. Well, we're not going to do group match one, group one, and then we're going to go straight to group two. We're going to do one group at a time.
Yeah.
So we're going to do group one first. And then we're going to do all the deals. Then we're going to, well, as I said, do all the deals and record them, but we're going to release the two deals a day.
Yeah.
So that's going to be, hopefully, the groups will only last about 3 days, hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully.
Now, we're hopefully planning to upload one in the afternoon.
Mm.
I'm not sure when in the afternoon, let's say one-ish or two-ish.
Yeah.
And then one in the evening, or not sure when.
Probably around 6-ish would be a good time.
Yeah, about 6, 7, 8, yeah. Somewhere around there. Then when that group's done, we'll do the same group 2, 3 and 4. When we come to the quarterfinals, we're going to do one a day when it reaches the quarterfinals.
Yep.
The quarterfinal one will be uploaded. We'll try our best to make it in between the afternoon and evening.
Yeah.
And then the next day will be quarterfinal two.
Yeah.
Third, and then the fourth. Semi-finals will be exactly like the quarters, one a day. There's only two deals. So it'll be semi-final one, and then semi-final two the next day. Same thing, we're going to try and put them in between the evening and afternoon. Now the bronze and finals will be in the evening.
Yeah.
So, yeah. That will probably make it better because it'll be more entertaining. I mean, but this is only personal to me. I feel like finals don't feel right at like 2 p.m.
I know what you mean, yeah.
It feels better if it's at the evening.
Yeah.
So, those are the upload schedules. Now, we can't guarantee every match.
No. Like we discussed earlier, we'll have to draw it or come to another arrangement.
If that happens in the bronze or finals...
Yeah, that would be an issue.
It will be an issue, but we will delay... That video, we put up
a notice.
And they just say a note saying it's delayed.
Yeah.
Unforeseen
circumstances.
Yeah. So if it's in the knockout rounds,
Yeah.
For example, both of my decks are playing against each other in the semi-finals, and my brother can't make it, me and Adam will discuss.
Yeah.
Say who's more likely. We'll go through our personal tests, tournaments. And we'll see through that, to see if they've dealt each other.
Yeah.
If they have, they'll be like, right, they've dealt twice, and Red Eyes or Ra or Karibo or Destiny Heroes have won both meetings.
Yeah.
And they'll be like, right, we base it off that, and then we make them.
Yeah.
So, yeah. After each match, in the group stages, that is, we will show a screenshot of what the group standings are.
Yeah.
So you don't have to say, Red Ice won. Did they qualify? Because they lost one game. Instead of, like, you try to figure out and wait until the quarterfinals. Before the quarterfinals and semis and bronze and finals will start, we put up a small video saying, this is what the quarterfinals looks like. And then this is what the semis, and then this is the bronze, and this is the finals. And then after the finals, we'll see the top three, well, the fourth, third, and second, and then the champion. And I think that's it to talk about the timings.
That's it. Yeah, that's about it. All on this as well.
Nice. Right then. A quick shout out, as we said multiple times in this video. Yep. We're going to be doing a podcast soon. We're still thinking of a name of the podcast, because we're going to do two different ones.
Yeah.
You see? We're going to do a Yu-Gi-Oh! Based one, and then we're going to do a casual one where we talk about anything.
Yeah, we've got a few ideas for that, you know, becoming films, comic books, something like that, you know.
We still haven't got a name for either of the Discords, of the podcast names.
Yeah. If you think you know one, leave a comment and we might use it.
Aye. And we'll probably think one of one in a, after this video ends.
Yeah.
This is, it's kind of a podcast, but it's not.
Yeah, I know what you mean. This video.
It's just the rules and ban lists and stuff. So yeah, I think that's it from me.
That's it from me as well. Yeah. Well, thank you all for tuning in. We hope to see you in the World Cup tournament, and we will see who will win. Thank you all one more time.
Don't forget to like, subscribe.
Yeah, like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you like. And see you next time. Bye. Inside my head, I'm fired up, tired of the way that things have been.